Welcome to another edition of A Conversation with Dr. Donna Hanlon, our Superintendent of Schools for Wacomico County Public Schools. All right, Dr. Hanlon, we're almost to Thanksgiving. Oh, can you believe
No.
30 years already gone?
Yeah.
It's been amazing. So let's start talking a little bit about some of the great things that have already happened here in the 2019-20 school year.
Yeah, well, wow, a lot. A lot of great things have been happening just across the system. So if I can just hit on a few, we continue to get great feedback on from our financial systems. We were awarded for the seventh time the Meritorious Budget Award from the Association of School Business Officials, which is very important because of our fiscal responsibility. Great things happening in the schools, you know, from our athletic teams going forward to the playoffs, and our bands doing really well in competitions this fall. We continue with Parent University, which is based upon feedback from parents about things they'd like to learn more about, including College Boot Camp, where we work with students and families on admissions essays and the financial aid forms that they have to fill out. We just had the comptroller at Pinehurst Elementary School, Comptroller Francho, in partnership with Junior Achievement. The Kindness Initiative, we have the Dance for Kindness that we're always very happy to participate with. So STEM events at Salisbury Middle School, just I could go on and on. Students, we had a Y-High student who won or is a finalist in an arts competition for the I Voted sticker. Right. And so we're really proud of her on the state level. JROTC, sorry, I could just keep going on.
Keep going.
JROTC was recognized by the Daughters of the American Revolution with a flag that flew over Congress and a citation for the great work that they do with leadership development with students. So I'll stop there and let you ask another question.
So we recently had Dr. Britt Kerwin in Salisbury at Warwick to speak to the community. You were the moderator of that, and the topic, of course, was the future of education in Maryland.
Sure.
What do you hope parents in the community came away from his appearance here in Salisbury?
I think that the whole purpose or the objective of a number of community organizations coming together to support that, bringing Dr. Kerwin here to speak with the community, was all about making sure that our community understands what's been happening with the Kerwin Commission, the Commission on Innovation and Excellence in Education, because the final outcomes of that work will have a major impact on not only our financing or the funding that we get for public education, but in a number of policy areas. So that was a wonderful evening filled with lots of information. Parents and community members had an opportunity to ask questions. So I feel like we achieved the purpose of updating the community on the work of that group that's been going on for a couple of years now.
All right, very good. All right, so we're coming up on that time of year where we have a lot of delays, you know, with fog and possibly snow. And, you know, one of the things parents often talk about is, you know, what is the policy or what's the procedure of deciding whether it's going to be a delay or it's a school cancellation?
Okay. Well, I get that question a lot also. So it is all about student safety as what it comes down to. But we have staff members from our transportation office who are out early in the mornings checking on conditions at the most far-reaching areas of our community. And then they will touch base with our Director of Transportation, Desmond Hughes, and together they will also talk with surrounding school systems to find out what are you seeing, and making the decision together or making a recommendation. They'll call Mrs. Miles, who's our Assistant Superintendent for Student and Family Services, and she becomes part of that conversation. And then finally, by probably 5 o'clock at the latest, I get that phone call and make that ultimate decision on whether we will continue as in normal on normal operations, or whether we'll delay or close. We try not to close, but ultimately student safety is the most important thing.
Right. Well, we're just about to wrap things up. Is there anything you would like to talk about as we wrap up today?
Well, I know that one of the issues that has been on lots of parents' minds and been on our minds a lot has to do with student discipline. And I just want to assure the community that we are engaged in some very in-depth conversations about on that topic. I would just remind the community that the vast majority of our students are doing exactly what they're supposed to be doing and that they're in school for the right reasons learning. But when we have students who are not so willing to comply with our expectations, then there are disciplinary consequences. And we're looking at those consequences, but we are reaching out beyond our own school system and talking with, we have a great partnership with the state's attorney, Jamie Dykes, our own sheriff's office, who we have school resource officers in our schools, so obviously we have a very positive relationship there. The Department of Juvenile Services, the Department of Social Services, just those entities that work with us to think about how can we hold students and parents of students sometimes more accountable for students' behavior in school, while at the same time we're working on interventions to prevent those kinds of behaviors that are occurring. So we are, as I said, very engaged in conversations and planning, looking at new strategies to make a difference with that small portion of our population that wants to disrupt our schools.
Well, very good. And of course, we thank you very much for your time. As always,
absolutely,
we hold these conversations with Dr. Hanlon once a month to tell us about what's going on in Wicomico County Public Schools. We'll see you next time on A Conversation with Dr. Hanlon. We'll be right back.